Now আমরা শুনবো সামস রাজি শপনিলের কাছ থেকে BIFFL similar kind of presentation on financing. Again, এটাও আমরা সেতু বন্ধন তৈরি করতে চাই BIFFL এর সাথে আপনাদের, এই জন্য তাদেরকে ডাকা.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And before I proceed to my presentation, I would like to thank Mr. Ananto Ahmed for allowing BIFFL to represent in this very auspicious moment, auspicious ceremony, I would like to say. And before approaching, I would like to share with you some brief about BIFFL and me. BIFFL is also a government-owned organization which was established back in the year of 2011 under Ministry of Finance. And as long as the paid-up capital is concerned, BIFFL is the largest non-banking financial institution rightly existent in Bangladesh. And actually, today's agenda is concerning about the green one. Sustainability, green, and energy efficiency all are like siblings. They all are correlated to each other very closely. So today's in my presentation, I would like to accentuate more on the sustainable financing, which is operated by Bangladesh Infrastructure Finance Fund Limited. So. let's have a look at what's the purpose of the sustainable financing in BIFFL. First, there is always investment is concerned. It's in any non-banking financial institution. We are also not an anomaly here. We have to invest, but that should be environmentally responsible. And then we have to save the earth. And there is the unit structure. Particularly, this sustainable finance unit was established back in 2014, which is have currently four officials, including one unit head. Unfortunately, is not present here. Presently, is in Dubai. And technical unit of BIFFL supports the sustainable finance unit as long as pertinent technical assistance and expertise are concerned. I am actually the head of the technical department, and I have got three more officials there who continuously support us in implementing the projects, which is actually maintained by the sustainable finance unit. And this is our focused areas. I think Jahid Bhai has already mentioned a lot of the things, because both ITCOL and BIFFL actually works almost similarly. But there is a basic difference also, but more or less, the both organization works similarly. As long as the auto bricks are concerned, we are currently working with around 25 auto brick factories all around the country, and we have already financed around 10 brick fields. And in our pipeline, there are more than around 15 brick fields we are actually considering to finance in the coming days. And then we also work with the utility solar power, scale solar power. But apart from that, we are now currently considering two megawatt scale power projects, one in Patgram Lalmonirhat and the other in the Cox's Bazar area. Both are 5 megawatt projects, and we are working very hard to actually make the things implemented. And finally, we also work for the green buildings. If any of the ventures who are looking forward to have a green building for their premise, for their office space, for their working space, they are very much welcome to BIFFL. They can consult with us. We can provide them the advisory services, and also we can have sufficient financing if they want from us. And we have some potential areas we'd like to accentuate on. That is energy efficiency, waste treatment and recycling, which includes the WTP, STP, ETP. And these are the current services we actually providing in BIFFL, advisory in both technical and financial aspects. We provide term loan, low-cost term loan, and syndication participation. And future service syndication will be continuing as we are doing right now. And awareness build-up convention, we have already added to conventions which were very much appreciated by the participants, and this year we have got a bigger prospect, so we want to arrange a convention which will be based on the PPP, that means the public-private partnerships and green initiatives. And we'll also have a plan to train our aspirated participants in collaboration with our development partners, namely JICA, World Bank, Asian Development Bank, KfW, FMO France, and AFD. Let's have a look in our refinancing scheme that will be, I think, very much handy for many of us here. That is the Renewable Energy and Environment Friendly Financiable Sector Refinancing Scheme, which is actually sponsored by our central bank, which is Bangladesh Bank. The fund amount is around 200 crore, and the deadline is not fixed yet. It is also under speculation that the deadline will be finalized very soon. The amount of per project is around, lower amount is 1 crore BDT, and the highest can be 30 crore. We have already 47 projects in our pipeline, and the interest rate is around, maximum is 9%. It can be negotiated further based on the prospects and other particulars of that project. And the tenure, I think, is 5 to 10 years. What Jahid Bhai actually said, that ITCOL is the only financial institution which have got more tenures, but I would like to add that BIFFL, I think, is no different than ITCOL. So if you want from us a bigger tenure, I think we can have a provision for that. And the grace or moratorium period is 6 months to 18 months based on the specifications and other relevant particulars of that particular projects. Our featured areas for this refinance scheme is solar energy, biogas, wind energy, waste treatment, recycling, energy efficiency, green building, and obviously auto bricks. And let's moving on. This is another very much, I would like to say, it's a very flagship type of projects of BIFFL, that is financing brick kiln efficiency improvement projects, which are sponsored by both ADB and Bangladesh Bank. The fund amount is, although it's USD 50 million, but it can be actually further ameliorated in the future. Deadline is extended till December 2018, but it will be extended further, I believe, because the tremendous response we have found and we have received from the potential sponsors around the country. And the amount per project, I think we can finance 50% of project cost, but we can actually finance more based on the equity and other particulars. The interest rate is maximum is 9%, but it can be further negotiated, that I have already mentioned. Tenure is eight and a half years, but it can be actually further negotiated, and the grace period is 18 months like before. And this one is actually very much promising, and at the same time, it's very much relevant to the agenda of today's occasion here. That is the Energy Efficiency and Conservation Promotion Financing Project, which is actually sponsored by JICA, which is the fund amount. I think there is a bit of anomaly here. The fund amount, I think, is around 1,000 crore and 500 crore for ITCOL and 500 crore for BIFFL. So we are the sole two participants for this particular project to implement. I don't know much about ITCOL, but as long as the BIFFL's portion is concerned, the 500 million has already been not disbursed, but already been actually ascertained to particular agency, particular companies and agencies. So this particular phase, we don't have enough funding. So if you contact us, I think we're very sorry right now, but hopefully in the next phase, we can entertain you if you want us. And amount per project is negotiable. I don't want to quantify the amount here because it's very much varying from projects to projects. And interest rate, I think this is probably the lowest interest rate in Bangladesh current now that any financial institution or bank can offer, which is 4%. And the tenure is 8 years, up to 8 years, but it's negotiable. And grace period is, I think it's very much lucrative. I think what other organizations actually provide this 2 years grace period. Featured areas is fertilizer, paper, RMG, glass, cement, steel, food, telecom industry, green building, and home appliances. But for this particular phase, majority of our fund actually has gone for the ready-made garment sector. Few have gone for the cement sector and steel sector. But we want to really diversify the fields in the upcoming phases. We don't want to make ourselves limited or confined to particular industry. We want to actually diversify more and more. So hopefully in the next phase, we can have broader aspects, and we can have other fields to have consideration. Okay, this is our strategic plan based on our in-house based on our in-house study and other sorts of things. You can have a look that by the year of 2020 we have got a plan of investing 19,857.88 taka in the sectors that I've already mentioned in my previous slides. So that's a big amount. So overall, we have a plan. If we can accumulate all this amount, there is an amount of 71,000 crore, around 72,000 crore BDT that we have got a plan to invest in the sectors we have already mentioned in the previous slides. These also are the project's targets in numerical term, that how many projects we are on to actually associate with in the coming 5 years. So these are all numbers. And in particular, we have got an energy target in the coming years, which is very much relevant to today's ceremony, and want to accentuate. And that's the renewable energy. We have got a plan to be associated with projects which can make around 260 megawatt of power. So that's I don't want to say that's ambitious, but I want to say that's very much challenging, taking accounts all sorts of odds and all sorts of limitations we have to face in our proceedings. And finally, I really want to thank Mr. Ananta and his team to support us, because we all know that charity begins at home. So we were very much aware that our own office space would be green. Our own office space will be certified by USGBC, and that is why we have implemented, I think, with the help of Mr. Ananta and his team, we have implemented a tremendous and fantastic job, and I want to give some clips of our new office space. So that is the new office space of BIFFL. I think there should be a round of applause for Mr. Ananta and his team. They have done a tremendous job. They have done a brilliant job to make these things happen, because it was not easy. It was not easy to convince all the government officials and all other board of directors to make these things happen. But finally, we have done this, and we are very much optimistic that we will have the certification in the next 2 months or something like that. So these are some of the images you can see. So I don't want to linger it anymore. Thank you. If you have any questions, please, you can ask.
আমাদের দুটো অর্গানাইজেশনই, ইটকল এবং বিএফএফএল, কিছু সিমিলারিটি আছে, কিছু ডিফারেন্স আছে। আমি যেটা বলতে চাই আপনাদেরকে সেটা হচ্ছে যে, ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ এ প্রজেক্ট, গো টু দ্যাম, টেল দ্যাম, সি ইফ দে ক্যান হেল্প, বিকজ দেয়ার বিজনেস ইজ টু হেল্প ইউ। সো ইটস এ মিউচুয়াল বেনিফিট টু বোথ, ইটস এ উইন উইন সিচুয়েশন। ওকে, if you are not qualified or is not viable, they will say thank you.